Yo guys, what's going on? Robert Warshak here, and I'm going over the top 5 best legendaries that you can make with the new Scholomance Academy cards. We've been in class roughly a week now. I believe we've learned a lot. We've played hundreds of games, and these are the new cards that stand out to me the most and seemingly are a very safe craft and fit into a bunch of different decks. Also, just a quick note, this is not in any particular order. All of these legendaries are really good in their respective decks. So based on basically which decks you want to play, these are safe cards to craft for those decks. So looking at our first one's going to be the Speaker. It's a dual class card between Druid and Shaman. So far, this has almost been an auto include into most Druids that I see. A lot of Shamans are playing this card as well because Shamans did get a good amount of really expensive, very powerful spells this expansion. The fact that it has Rush and Wind Fury makes it so when you play this card later in the game and you play a big spell, it gets buffed up and can trade into other minions. It's only 3 mana, so you can play it in the early game as well on curve. And if your opponent doesn't deal with it, you can follow up with a spell and do a significant amount of damage. So basically, no matter when you play this card in the game, if it's unchecked, you kind of just win because it has Wind Fury. In worst case, you're going to kill 1 to 2 minions because it has Rush. Moving to our Mage and Rogue dual class legendary, we have Miss Baroth. She's a 5 mana 2-1, but the stats aren't why you play her. She's summoned 2 random 5-cost minions. Secretly pick one that dies when it takes damage. This is the new illusion card. It's very annoying to deal with, and being able to basically play a 2-1 body along 2-5 drop minions is a really big tempo play. Most of the time, it's going to kill 1 to 2 minions. A lot of the times, you're going to get chip damage in there. Rogue and Mage both benefit from putting in damage in the middle of the game so they can finish you off later in the game with their cards like Avis, Fireballs, Frostbolts, all of that good stuff. Overall, she does every time someone has played her against me, it's been a hassle to deal with, and she just seems like a really strong card right now. Moving to the Warrior / Paladin dual class legendary, we've got Lord Baroth. He's a 3 mana 3-2, but we don't play him for the 3 mana 3-2 part. His ability is insane. Battlecry set the health of all other minions to 1 on the battlefield, and his death rattle is deal 1 to all other minions. So he's a board clear in himself for 3 mana. That is crazy. You can also combo him if you're a Paladin. Consecration does a fantastic job. If you're a Warrior, you can cast Bladestorm. You also can sword and board him for a board cleared that way. So just overall, for any control deck or even almost any mid-range deck, he's a really, really good card, and I've been finding him to be like a core part of the control warrior deck that I built and should be posting up later this week. Moving to the High Abbess, the Paladin / Priest dual class legendary. She is insane in Librem deck. She's a 4 mana 3/6 spell burst. Cast a spell from your deck and it targets her if possible. So if you're familiar with Librem Paladin, the number one deck, basically the best deck right now, she can cast Hope on herself. She can cast the new 5 mana, give her +8/+8. She can cast Wisdom. So overall, she's just really, really good value. Gets the buffs out of your deck, cast it on her for free. Priests are using her because they're copying her and they're just making a big board full of high abesses, which is really annoying in itself as well. And for 4 mana 3/6 in stats are already good in her, basically spell burst just kind of puts her over the edge. So very, very good card here. Moving to the Mind Reader, this is basically everybody's number one hated card right now, whether you're playing against Priest as a combo deck, as a control deck, as a tempo deck. I mean, this card is just really, really annoying. I don't know if they'll ever change her. I can maybe see a nerf to her in the future, but right now she's exceedingly powerful if you're a Priest player, because if you're playing against a combo deck, looking at the new combo mage, possibly the new turtle mage, you can just shut down their combo by itself for 2 mana because you're able to swap hands and decks with your opponent for an entire turn. So playing her later in the game, you steal all their combo pieces, you play it out. Also, it's good against OTK Druid. You just play their Moonfires and Bloom Blossoms and maybe even a Malygos if you got the mana, because Druid has infinite mana because you just stole their hand. And definitely one of the cards that, if there's something to get nerfed from the set, this is something I would definitely be thinking that's going to get nerfed. As of now, Blizzard did announce in their AMA that they did not, so maybe she'll go untouched, but this card is just insane. Moving to the Instructor Fireheart, a 3 mana 3/3 Shaman legendary, no dual class here. She discovers a spell that costs 1 or more, and if you play it this turn, you repeat the effect. So basically, you just continuously get to play spells if you pick ones that you have the mana for. She's also super fun in Quest Shaman, which I'll be posting a video on very, very soon as well. But she fits in Burn Shaman, she fits in Tempo Shaman, she fits in Control Shaman, she fits in Highlander Shaman. As you can see, she's a card that just fits in basically any Shaman deck that you're going to want to play and build, and this is why she's definitely a solid craft if you're a Shaman fan. Moving to the Doctor, the dual class between the Warrior and Rogue, he's a 5-mana 4-4 rush, which means he can attack a minion in the second he's played, and then whenever he attacks, which is going to happen because he has rush, your weapon gets +1/+1. He's an absolute staple right now in any sort of weapon warrior, quest warrior, control warrior. He's also very good in rogues because rogues right now are playing hook scimitars and the sharp blade. And I'm sure as the expansion progresses forward, we're going to have more and more builds where we're going to have really strong weapons. So overall, Doctor is just a fantastic pick if you're interested. I've actually been playing with this guy a lot recently because I've been hammering out a lot of warrior games, and he's just really, really good, especially with the Wrench Caliber or the new Scythe that came out for Warrior this set as well. Moving to our first neutral here, we have Headmaster Kel'Thuzad. Fantastic control card, fantastic Highlander card. He's the 5-mana 4-6, so stats he's already good. Spell Burst, if the spell destroys any minions, summon them. This is a very, very powerful ability. If you look at Shamans having 1-mana Torrents, if you look at Priests being able to play Shadow Word Death for 2-mana and kill a minion, if you're looking at Warrior, if you're lucky, you can play Brawl and have them live, which is quite a highlight. But worst case, you Shield Slam a minion with Headmaster. It's a 1-mana steal, whatever the hell you want. You can also use Blade Storm, which will also clear up a bunch of minions and take them. So Headmaster, very, very good card in basically any deck that you like right now because he is a neutral. He's not really found in aggro decks, so he's mainly for us, you know, slower, maybe mid-range slash control decks, but still really, really good card, and that's because, again, he is a neutral. Moving to the first legendary neutral weapon ever introduced into Hearthstone, we have the Sphere. It's a 1-mana 0/4 at the start of your turn. Look at the top card. You can put that card on the bottom and lose 1 durability, so it's very similar to like the Scry effect in Magic, which is very, very good. Most of the time, this is found in Highlander decks, it's found in control decks, it's also found in OTK decks. So there's a wide, basically, spectrum of decks that this card is currently found in. And from what I've experienced and what I've played with it, it is really, really good because it can find you a lot of outs you normally wouldn't be able to find, being able to get that extra look at a card if the top card of your deck really isn't something that you're wanting that turn. And last but not least, we have the Druid Legendary, the new Omu. The 6-mana 5-4 stats aren't why we play him. Spell Burst, Refresh, your Mana Crystal. So this is currently found in basically every single form of Druid, very similar to the previous dual-classed Druid slash Shaman Legendary we went over earlier. He's found in the Malagos Druid, he's found in the Beast Druid, he's found in the Hybrid Mount Cellar Dragon Druid. It's just the ability to basically refresh your Mana Crystals after you play him is just really good because Druid has a ton of very cheap spells to be able to activate his ability. Whether or not you're using this for a combo or tempo on board, it doesn't even matter. He's just a free body most of the time, worst case scenario, and best case scenario, you're pulling off a big combo and killing your opponent in a single turn. That wraps up what I think are the top 10 legendaries to come out of this set that you guys are pretty safe crafting with what I've seen. If there's anything I happen to miss out on, anything you want to add, feel free to put that in the comment section below. If this helped any of you, throw a like, let me know. It really helps out the video on the YouTube algorithm side. And I will see you guys in the next video. Of course, I am Robert Warshak, and happy whatever the hell day it is.